بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We still continue the lesson of Do you really love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We said last time, try to compare yourself with anyone who really loved him and how his life and how his level changed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see one of his companions. 70,000 angels will follow his janazah. Just ask yourself, how many angels will follow our janazah? One of his companions, the malaika, the angel washed his body when he died. Ask yourself, who will wash our body when we die? Angel from hell or angel from Jannah? One of his companions, a shaitan afraid from him. Just imagine, a shaitan afraid from one person? Yes. Why? Because every time a shaitan tried to whisper to him, he do the opposite. To whisper to make bad deed, he increase his good deed. That's why shaitan ran away from him to avoid the increasement of his good deed. That try to ask yourself how much shaitan is close from you. Rasulullah ﷺ gave a good news to one of his companions that he would enter paradise without hisab. Ask yourself, are our good deeds and our patience qualify us to enter the Jannah without hisab? One of his companions, the angel shaded him with their wings and God spoke to him without a cover. Ask yourself, do we have a character for the people who will be at the shadow of Allah on the Day of Judgment? One of his companions, al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, praised Allah a lot. Praised his Lord for making one of his companions among his nation. And he loved to hear the Quran from him because he read it by his heart, not by his tongue. He felt every single word in it. Ask yourself, do we really read the Quran in this way or no? One of his companions become the most one know for what is halal and what is haram. He will be a leader, imam for all the scholars in the Day of Judgment. Ask yourself, for which group you will be a leader in the world and in hereafter. And one of his companions become the famous one of ilm al-hadith, and another one in ilm al-sunnah, and another one in ilm al-tafsir. Just ask yourself, how much knowledge do you have from the Quran and the Sunnah? And another one, he famous by Abu al-Masakin, the father of every needy. He always take care of, he always give all his money for the sake of Allah, take care of every needy. He use your hand for the sake of Allah to give. And in the end, he lose his hand in the war for the sake of Allah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah tell he will enter al-Jannah flying with the wings of diamonds. Ask yourself, what we have sacrificed in our lives for the sake of Allah. This is the example for the people who really loved Rasulullah and their life changed from Muslim to believer. Now, let's ask ourselves, what is the effect of our messenger in our life? Do I act like him? Do I adopt some of his behavior? Do I follow his sunnah? Or no? When one of the companions disobeyed one of the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the order of the messenger in the war, they were defeated in this war. This is war of Uhud. What about us? How many orders we don't follow? How many sunnah do we miss it? If you really love him and love Allah, we must follow his steps to be successful. But the problem, that's why we have a big distance between us and Sahaba, because the way we treat the sunnah in our lives. Some of us treat the sunnah as a wonderful history of the great person. But we give ourselves permission to take from it as we want and leave what we don't want. And some other people think that the life of our messenger is a miracle, just miracle story, but not important to act on it. And some think that the sunnah is special just for the messenger, because he's the messenger, not for us. And another denied the sunnah completely. That's why we find a lot of distance, a big distance between us and the Sahaba, in receiving the meaning of the sunnah. When we say the sunnah of the messenger, we mean his way of life, not just in nawafil, we make it in the salah, or how they enter the bathroom, and how we drink, and etc., etc. Who teach us the salah? Allah said a salah is a fard for every Muslim. But who teach us the details? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The sunnah is a practice for every single ayah in the Quran Kareem. His life is very important to us to act and read. He didn't have a private life. All of his life is lesson for us. We are not talking or taking a lesson from a normal life. We speak about the best one. Act under the Quran. And the best one who know how to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All his actions, all his words, all his feelings, all his happiness, all his sadness, all of this were a follow-up from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never did anything by himself. And if he did, then Jibreel alayhi salam revealed it immediately to him, to confirming what he should do, or cancel it, or exchange it. That's why he is the walking Quran on the earth. We don't need to be walking Quran on the earth. At least try to be just one ayah. When I see you, I remember this ayah, because you act under it. In the end, we must follow the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remember his blessing. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned him in the Quran Kareem, he mentioned him as a blessing for us. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. Just remember the blessing of Allah. What kind of blessing Allah, you want to always remember it? Blessing of health? No. Blessing of money? No. Blessing of kids? No. What kind of blessing? Blessing of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who make you, who removed the darkness from our hearts, who united all the believers, who shared their homes and their monies together. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. It's an honor for us to celebrate the birth of Rasulullah sallam. But let us follow his sunnah, his steps. When the companions ask him, why Ya Rasulullah you fast every Mondays, he tells, because this is my birthday. We need to follow this sunnah. If you want to celebrate about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his birth, we must do as he did in his life, to fasting every Mondays. Just remember, our good deeds would never be accepted if you don't follow the sunnah. And prepare yourself in the day of judgment for two questions. You must have an answer for it. For whom and how? For whom did you do your good deeds? Did you make it for sake of Allah or another thing? And how did you do it, your good deed? You followed the sunnah of Rasulullah or you did it as you wanted?
صلى عليك الله يا خير الورى تعداد حبات الرمال وأكثرا صلى عليك الله ما غيث هما فوق السهول وبالجبال وبالقرى فوق السهول وبالجبال وبالقرى يا خير مبعوث بخير رسالة للناس يا خير الأنام وأطهرا
فاللهم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام صلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اجمعنا بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة ماء لا نظبأ بعدها أبدا وصلى اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحاب الأخيار وسلم تسليما كثيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك استغفرك ربي وأتوب إليك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.